Hello, ServiceNow scripters. Welcome back to Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform. On the next batch of videos, you're on your home stretch of videos. All the videos from now to the end are going to be pertaining to all things Glide. So we have so many different libraries within ServiceNow for JavaScript. Glide record is something that Chuck has already talked to you all about. We're going to be doing a lot more different things around Glide, and we're going to go through them one at a time. So the first one we're going to look at is GlideSystem. So you're all pretty used to seeing this, gs.info. And GlideSystem, the GS part of it, is so much more than just logging statements. So we're going to look more further in this video into GlideSystem. So the GlideSystem API, often referred to as GS, this API is pretty much like the backbone of server-side scripting in ServiceNow. And it offers a lot more than just logging. It has methods to interact with the ServiceNow platform, from things like user session management to querying records. So the first section of GlideSystem that we're going to look at is user information. So user information is pretty helpful. One of the very easiest things that we can do is something like, what is the current username of the user? And we'll say gs.getUserName, and go ahead and run that script, and you'll see that my username for this account is admin. Pretty straightforward. That should be the same thing as you too if you logged in as admin. Another thing that we can do is stuff like get their user roles or get their ID. But before we do that, we have to dive further into GlideSystem with a specific user object. And so that can be done by saying, let's create a new variable called current user, and we're going to say gs.getUser. So now GlideSystem is saying, hey, we're trying to find out more information about the logged in user right now. Go ahead and get that information and store it in their variable. So we're going to store it in that current user variable. Now that we have that, we can do some fun stuff like, what's the current user ID of the person? So when I say user ID, I mean the unique ID for that person inside of the database. Get ID. If we run that, there's my unique sys ID for my user account. And then other things that we can do is find out all the user roles. And current user dot, I think, get roles. That's right. Get roles. So if I run that script, it's going to be a doozy. It's going to get all the roles that my account has. And it's a lot because I'm admin. So it's going to grab a lot of different roles. But from there, I have a nice list of whoever is logged in's roles so that I can use it for my scripting. It already has put it into an array for me. So if I run a for loop through this array, I can actually get very individualized with that long list of roles. All right, next. So in GS, our GlideSystem, we actually have a lot of information that we can get about our instance. So let's take a look at that. So say I want to know the name of my instance, so that we can refer to it inside our logging statements, or we can put it in our emails, or we can build URLs with it. All we want to do is GS and use get property. So get property is a very interesting method within GlideSystem. What it's doing is there is a system properties table. And if I show you, you can type, go into your filter navigator and type in system properties. And you'll see that there is a list of system properties that you can go to set any number of things. And it's all the name of a property and the value of the property. That's the entire list of system properties. And so when we say get property, we're going to say get a specific property, and in this example, instant name, and tell us what the value is set for that. And this instant name property is default for all of our instances. We have that instance name property in all of our instances, and we can rely on it being accurate whenever we run the script. So if I run the script, There it is. There's my personal developer instance name, dev145418, and it was able to get it via a system property. Likewise, maybe I don't want just the instance name. I want the entire URL for my instance. The URL for this instance is, we're going to do get property again. And this one is, it's called glide.servlet.uri. And if I run that, you'll see that there's my entire URL for my instance. It's a very convenient way to get the instance URL instead of having to build it yourself whenever you, for example, build a link and you want someone to be able to get to your instance. Say you might put it in an email. And so that's a really simple one-line code for you to be able to get your instance URL. And even from there, I can actually start adding to it if I want to link them to specific places, like maybe I want to send them to the service portal. So if I put plus SP at the very end, you'll see that my URL that I'm providing, it now says my instance and then slash SP, which is service portal. So just a really cool way, very fast way to build your links for your scripts. And then finally, I just want to show you some random silly things that shows that there's a lot of things within GlideSystem. And sometimes you might just need to look up the documentation for GS and see what's available to you. But just to get your brain moving, there is stuff like, what's the beginning of last week? Or what's the beginning of next month? Let's run that. And you'll see that as of today, a week ago was December 4th. And the start of next month is January 1st. So just interesting shortcuts that you have available to you. Another fun thing is gs.info, gs.isLoggedIn. So is logged in. So if I press run, yeah, I'm logged in. True. Why would I need this? Well, this script can be run in a lot of different places. Maybe this script was running for a user. So yeah, they're logged in. But what if you need to run a script only if it's not based off of a user session, but it's based off of the system? So maybe that script is running just on a random flow that's not attached to a user, then it'll show false. Now you know that this script is running for no particular person. And so some of those methods that are inside GlideSystem can be pretty helpful depending on your context and what you're trying to run. So again, look it up. You'll be surprised by all the fun little shortcuts that you have available to you. But I just wanted to show you some user-based ones, some instance-based ones, and then just some random fun ones. Cool. I'll see you in the next video. And I gotta make sure my mic is on this time. Oh my goodness.